أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. As you must be knowing, we shall be starting today with ayah number 35 of Surah Hamim As-Sajda. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم. وإما ينزغنك من الشيطان نزغ فاستعذ بالله إنه هو السميع العليم. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربنا الهمنا رشدنا واعذنا من شرور انفسنا. اللهم انس وحشتنا في قبورنا وارحمنا بالقران العظيم. اللهم اجعله لنا اماما ونورا وهدى ورحمه. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وآناء النهار واجعله لنا حجة يا رب العالمين آمين. I told you the groups, the Makki surahs of two groups, that is fourth and fifth. The main theme of these surahs is Tawheed. But Tawheed has two aspects. One is theoretical aspect, that is Tawheed in creed, what our ulama call Tawheed fil aqidah. So Tawheed in creed is a theoretical aspect of Tawheed. And there is the other aspect, Tawheed in practice. To be a muwahhid really, you have to fulfill the requirements of both the aspects of Tawheed. But mostly among the religious minded people of the Muslim Ummah today, the maximum importance is attached to the Tawheed fil Aqeedah. All the arguments going on, munazaras, all go around some issues which are concerning the creed or aqidah. While I think in our times the practical aspect of Tawheed is more important than the theoretical aspect. And let me quote here a couplet of Allama Iqbal. He says, Zinda quwwat thi zamane mein ye Tawheed kabhi. There was a time when Tawheed used to be a very big living force in this world. Aur ab kya hai? Faqat ek masla hai ilm e kalam. It has become a debating issue of the scholastic knowledge, and that's all. So in these surahs, which we started from Surah Az-Zumar, then Surah Al-Mumin, then Surah Al-Sajda, and then we shall be reading today Surah Ash-Shura. These four surahs of the Quran are very important regarding this practical Tawheed. The theoretical Tawheed, in all the Makki surahs you find it. And maximum emphasis at that time was on theoretical, because they believed in false gods, they were worshipping idols, they thought the angels are daughters of Allah, the Christians thought that Jesus is the son of Allah. Some of the Jews had said Uzair was the son of Allah, and so on and so forth. someone is God incarnate. So these things were more important at that time. But in our time, the collective system, the state, concept of state, and this system of politico-socio-economic life, these three aspects of life becoming one system, the politico-socio-economic, this aspect of human life has become much, much, much more important than this theoretical side. Now, among these four surahs, number one, Surah Az-Zumar, أَنِعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ الدِّينِ Worship Allah, but keeping your absolute obedience exclusive for Allah. Don't include anybody else as absolute for absolute obedience. Obedience there can be, but under the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can obey your elders, your teachers, your parents, your rulers, leaders, but not in anything which implies the disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then it becomes shirk. In the same way, love of Allah. You can love everything. Your children, your spouses, your parents, your city, your country, your nation, mankind. Love of mankind is also something very good. But love of Allah should be supreme. If the love for anything or anyone becomes equal to love of Allah, it is shirk. It has to be beneath it. So that was the basic theme at the personal level. You have to be bondsmen to Allah exclusively. In the next surah, this was فَدْعُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Because the essence of ibadah is dua, prayer. So pray Allah, but keeping your obedience, absolute obedience, reserved exclusively for Him. Then your dua is dua. Otherwise, it is an exercise in futility. You are obeying Allah in some aspects and obeying someone else in other aspects, then Allah is not going to listen to you at all. Your prayers will be thrown back in your faces. Go away. Nothing doing. You have to obey me first. فَدْعُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Now, this is, so to say, a simile. This is a relationship. Allah and the Abd. Ibadah is obedience of Allah. Dua is the prayer from this bondsman to Allah. But then now, when this relationship is established, now you are, as an individual, a full mu'min. When this relationship is established fully, now it will extend out of your personality. Now it will take the form of da'wah. Da'wah and dua, the root is the same. Dua to Allah, dawa to people. Word is the same. But now you have to call people towards the way of Allah, towards the cause of Allah, towards the deen of Allah. Ya ayyuhanna asu'budu rabbakum. Worship Allah. Love Allah. Adore Allah. Obey Allah. So this is the subject matter of Surah Hamim Sajda. And the central theme is fixed by the ayah, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Whosoever, who can be better than the speech? Now the speech is the highest faculty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon human beings. This sight we have, but the animals have too. Some of the animals have more piercing sight than ours. There are certain animals who can see without light. We can't see. So this is nothing exclusive. Hearing, this faculty is also much more developed in animals. Smelling, most of the animals, they smell more. They gather more information through smelling. You see the dog smelling everything. He recognizes everything by smelling. The faculty which makes human being a human being is the faculty of speech. Highest faculty. In our brains, you know, the highest evolved area is called the gray matter. And in that gray matter, there are areas, area for sight, that is behind, on the back, and so forth. But the largest area is of speech. And it has two aspects. You understand what somebody else is saying. This is one aspect of the speech. And then you express yourself. This is the other aspect of the speech. And the largest area on the gray matter of our brain is concerning the speech. And here that word has been used. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا. Now this is the highest faculty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to the human beings. But the use of this faculty, now that is the difference. Some Hitler, some Bhutto, some other leader, he would use this faculty of speaking, addressing people, to become popular and a leader, a dictator. Some lawyer, he will use this faculty to earn money. He can express himself better. He can argue in a better way. That is why, even, you know, even hearing, for one hearing in the court, they can demand lakhs and lakhs of rupees. So this is because they can express in a better way. Law is the same. Every lawyer has the books. But how to present the case? But if some human being is using this faculty of speech solely to call people to Allah, so he is the highest. And that is the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. Best among you are those who understand Quran. This is this aspect of speech, understanding. This speech of Allah. What is Quran? Kalamullah. It is the speech of Allah. To be able to understand the Kalamullah and then to express it and convey it to the others. Whosoever devote themselves for this career, I should say career, not a side business, not a side issue, not a pastime, not a hobby, no, career. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. They, according to this hadith of Sahih of Imam Bukhari, they are the best among the Muslims. Now we shall see, because this medium of this da'wah, ilallah, is Quran. We have been reading, O Muhammad, give glad tidings through Quran. Warn people through Quran. Remind people through Quran. فَإِنَّمَا يَسَّرْنَاهُ بِلِسَانِكَ لِتُبَشِّرَ بِهِ الْمُتَّقِينَ وَتُنْزِرَ بِهِ قَوْمًا لُدَّهُ. We give the glad tidings through Quran. Warn through Quran. وَذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مَنْ يَخَافُ وَعِيدٍ. Remind people through Quran. Wherever he went, he recited the ayat of Allah. Not making his own discourses or speeches or sermons. No, 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 no. Wherever he went. Yatlu alayhim ayatihi, yatlu alayhim ayatihi, yatlu alayhim ayatihi, yatlu alayhim ayatihi. Four times in Quran this is repeated. Twice in Surah Al-Baqarah, once in Surah Al-Imran, and then again finally in Surah Al-Jum'ah. هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة. That is why in this surah, Quran is mentioned so many times and from so many angles that there are only two surahs more in the Quran, whole of the Quran, which can come near this surah regarding this aspect. One, Surah Bani Israel, and the other, Surah Al-Furqan. But here it is actually the medium of da'wah, ilallah. We have to call people towards Allah. But call people through what? Through Quran. This is the medium of da'wah. So we were reading the characteristics and the stations of the evolution of a character who is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one was ان الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكه. First, this relationship should be established between God and man. Allah is my Lord, and then he sticks with it. He's steadfast on it. He's firm on it. So first level is this. Then, now da'wah. From your personality, it should come out naturally. If some article is hot, heat will emit out of it itself. If you are sitting near a fire, well, heat will come to you. You don't have to make any effort to get heat out of the fire. It will itself come to you. If some big block of ice is placed near you, well, coldness will come to you itself. So if a person is really and fully mature as an abd of Allah, da'wah ilallah will emit from him, even if he doesn't make any effort, from his very presence, from his very personality, it will come out. As I've told you, this is the phenomenon of, this physical phenomenon. Heat from the fire, coolness from the ice. In the same way, a mature bondsman of Allah, from him this da'wah comes out. This is the second stage. And then third, due to this da'wah, there must be a conflict. People won't like it. People who have become lords of people, they are the masters, they are the rulers. How can they leave their place for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to rule? So a conflict is a must. Hence now, forbearance, steadfastness, perseverance, that is the third stage. وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاسَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاسَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. So the third ayah was, وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا. These three stations cannot be achieved but by those people only who are persevering, who are forbearing, who take all things patiently. وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ النَّزْغُونَ. And if perchance at some time you feel, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and through him Allah is addressing us, if we become da'is towards Allah, callers towards Allah, now if at some time Satan, he incites us and provokes us, go and fight. He has called a bad name to you, you reply in the same coin. He has done this good evil to you, reply in the same coin. For this Allah says, إِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ النَّزْغُونَ. If you feel such an incitement, always take this incitement that it is from Satan. تَسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. So take and ask for refugal of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Verily, he is listening everything and he is knowing everything. This subject has once before come in Surah Al-A'raf. وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ النَّزْغُ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. The only difference is here it is, إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. More emphasis. Otherwise the ayah is mostly the same as it appears in the end of Surah Al-A'raf. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارُ. And from among the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so these are the subjects which have come repeatedly. The night and the day, and the sun and the moon. These are the signs of Allah. So don't worship them. لا تسجدوا للشمس ولا للقمر. واسجدوا لله الذي خلقهن. Worship and prostrate before not the sun nor the moon. Prostrate before Allah who has created all of them. إِن كُنْتُمْ إِيَّاهُ تَعْبُدُونَ. If you really worship him alone. فَلِسْتَكْبَرُوا. And if they show arrogance, فَالَّذِينَ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ. So those who are very near to your Lord, that is the angels, highest order, الْمَلَائِكَةُ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ, who are very close to Allah, yusabbihuna lahu bil layli wan nahar. Day and night, they are glorifying Allah with His praise. Wahum la yasamun, and they never get tired of glorifying and praising Allah. This is the ayah of sajda. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنَّكَ تَرَى الْأَرْضَ خَاشِعَةً, and from his signs that you can see is that you see that the land is lying humbled, lying low, barren. فَإِذَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْهَا الْمَاءَ, and when we send down over it water, اِهْتَزَّتْ وَرَبَتْ, it stirs and swells, this life. إِنَّ الَّذِي أَحْيَاهَا, verily, He who has given life to this dead land, la muhyil mauta, He will give life to the dead also. Innahu ala kulli shayin qadir, verily, He is powerful over everything. Innal ladina yulhiduna fi ayatina la yakhfauna anha, verily, those who are trying to be crooked with our revelations, misinterpreting, they are not hidden from our eyes. We know them. أَفَمَنْ يُلْقَى فِي النَّارِ, so the one who will be thrown in fire, خَيْرٌ, is he better? Or أَمَّنْ يَاتِي آمِنًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, or the one who comes on the day of judgment in security and peace. اَمَلُوا مَا شَيْتُمْ, now do whatever you like. إِنَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ, whatever you are doing, Allah Ta'ala knows it and He is seeing it. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِالذِّكْرِ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ, verily, those who have disbelieved the admonition, the reminding, when it has come to them, وَإِنَّهُ لَكِتَابٌ عَصِيسٌ, they will be losers. And surely, this Qur'an is a mighty book. لَا يَعْتِيهِ الْبَاطِلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَلَا خَبٍ خَلْفِهِ, falsehood cannot attack this Qur'an, neither from front nor from the back. تَنْزِيلُ مِنْ حَكِيمٍ حَمِيدٌ, this is descending down a revelation of the one who is all-wise, all-praiseworthy. I told you, Qur'an is mentioned in this surah in so many ways. Let us count from the very beginning. First of all, we had the beginning. Ayah number 2. كِتَابٌ فُصِّلَتْ آيَاتُهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا لِقَوْمِ يَعْلَمُونَ بَشِيرًا وَنَزِيرًا فَعَرَضَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ. This is a book whose ayat, whose revelations are explained fully. And it has been made into an Arabic Quran so that you can understand. And this is the Bashir and Nazir. Muhammad is Bashir and Nazir on the basis of this book. Actually, Bashir and Nazir is this book, the bearer of the glad tidings and the warner. Now, for the second time, turn to ayah number 26. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَالْغَوْا فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ, and the disbelievers say, don't listen to this Quran. And when Muhammad recite this Quran to people, you hoot him, boo him, make noises, so that people cannot listen to it. If you want to be successful, because Quran is so mighty, it can influence people, it can possess them, it can move them, and then you will be the losers. So stop this Quran. And for the third time now, لَا يَعْتِيهِ الْبَاطِلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ, ayat 42, this Quran is so fortified that batil, falsehood, cannot attack it, neither from the front nor from behind. وَلَا مِنْ خَلْفِهِ تَنْزِيلٌ مِنْ حَكِيمٍ حَمِيدٌ مَا يُقَالُ لَكَ إِلَّا قَدْ قِيلَ لِرُسُلِ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, nothing has been said to you which was not said to the messengers who were before you. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَذُو مَغْفِرَةٍ وَذُو عِقَابٍ عَلِيمٍ, verily your Lord is the Lord of forgiveness, but at the same time, the Lord of painful punishment. وَلَوْ جَعَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَجَبِيًا, the fourth time, again Quran being mentioned. Had we made this Quran in some foreign language. لَقَالُوا, they would have said, لَوْلَا فُسِّلَتْ آيَاتُهُ, why not are its ayat, its revelations explained? أَعْجَمِيٌ وَعَرَبِي, is Ajami or Quran sent for the Arabi people? We are Arabs. Our language is Arabi. So there should have been an Arabic Quran. But now when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent Arabic Quran, they are not accepting it. قُلْ هُوَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هُدًى وَشِفَاءً, say, this Quran is for those who believe, guidance, as well as a healing, a medicine, a remedy. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ فِي آذَانِهِمْ وَقْرٌ, as for those who don't believe, in their ears is a heaviness. وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِمْ عَمَى, and this Quran has become a blindness for them. أُولَٰئِكَ يُنَادَوْنَ مِنْ مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ, it seems that they are being called from a very far off place. Muhammad is calling them in front of them, very near from them. But to them it seems the voice is coming from very far off distance. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ فَاخْتُلِفَ فِيهِ, and we had given Musa the book. But then there was differences concerning it arose. وَلَوْلَا كَلِمَةٌ سَبَقَتْ مِنْ رَبِّكَ, and if the word of your Lord had not passed for a definite period of time, نَقْوَضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ, all the things would have been settled and decided between them. وَإِنَّهُمْ لَفِي شَكِّ مِنْهُمْ مُرِيبٌ, and now they are in about this Quran, now they are in a very grave and disturbing doubt. They should have believed in Quran. Now this is the fifth time that Quran is being mentioned. وَإِنَّهُمْ لَفِي شَكِّ مِنْهُمْ مُرِيبٌ, مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلِنَفْسِهِ, whosoever does good deeds, for he does it for his own sake, for his own benefit. وَمَنْ أَسَاءَ فَعَلَيْهَا, and whosoever is committing bad deeds, well, the loss will be his. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظُلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ, and your Lord is not cruel to his and unjust to his servants. إِلَيْهِ يُرَدُّ عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ, to him is referred the knowledge of the hour, that السَّاعَةِ, when it will come. Nobody knows except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not even the malaika. Nobody knows. وَمَا تَخْرُجُ مِنْ سَمَرَاتٍ مِنْ أَكْمَامِهَا, and whichever fruit comes out from its sheaths. وَمَا تَحْمِلُ مِنْ أُنْثَى, and whosoever female, man or animal, carries in her womb any child, وَلَا تَضَعُ, and whosoever bears it, إِلَّا بِعِلْمِهِ, all these things are in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is bearing whom? Who has a son in her womb? Who has a daughter in her womb? When she will bear the child. وَيَوْمَ يُنَادِيهِمْ أَيْنَ شُرَكَائِي, and imagine the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to them, where are those whom you associated with me? قَالُوا آذَنَّا كَمَا مِنَّا مِنْ شَهِيدٍ, they will say, we declare it to you, our Lord, none of us will witness to it. Now we don't believe in any associate with you. That is a matter of the past. وَظَلَّ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَدُونَ مِنْ قَبْلُ, and those they used to call upon before, they will be lost to them. وَظَنُّوا مَا لَهُمْ مِنْ مَحِيسٍ, and they will come to believe that now for them there is no escape. لَا يَسَمُّ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ دُعَاءِ الْخَيْرِ, man is never tired of praying for good. Oh Allah, give me this thing. Oh Allah, give me this thing. Oh Allah, give me this thing. وَإِنْ مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ فَيَئُوسُ الْقَنُوطُ, and if some evil touches him, he is absolutely cast down, depressed and despaired. وَلَئِنْ أَذَقْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِنَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ ضَرَّاءٍ مَسَّتْهُ, and if we make him taste our mercy after the harm that had come to him, لَيَقُولَنَّ هَذَا لِي, he would say, it's mine, I have done it. I have changed my conditions. Through hard work, I have changed my lot. وَمَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمَةً, and I don't think that ever is going to come and there is going to be any day of judgment. وَلَا يُرْجِعْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي, and if I am returned to my Lord, is the same subject, we found it and we read it in Surah Al-Kahf. ان لي عنده لحسنى. For me, with him will be all everything good. Wealth, etc., all the goodly things. فَلَنُنَبِّئَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِمَا عَمِلُوا. No. We shall tell these disbelievers what they had done. وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ غَلِيظٍ. And we shall make them taste a harsh chastisement. وَإِذَا أَنْعَمْنَا عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ أَعْرَضَ وَنَأَىٰ بِجَانِبِهِ. And when we bless a man, he turns away and withdraws to a side. Then he is not praying to us. He has all the money, all the comforts, whatever he needs, there is plenty of it. So now he doesn't pray to us. وَإِذَا أَنْعَمْنَا عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ أَعْرَضَ وَنَأَىٰ بِجَانِبِهِ. Turns to his side. وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ فَذُو دُعَاءٍ عَرِيضٍ. And when some harm comes to him, now he has very long prayers. Oh Allah, oh Allah, oh Allah. Now du'a'in ariz, prayers very long. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ كَفَرْتُمْ. Again, Quran mentioned here. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, think, if this Quran which I am presenting is really from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ثُمَّ كَفَرْتُمْ, and then you reject it, you don't accept it. مَنْ أَضَلُّ مِمَّنْ هُوَ فِي شِقَاقٍ بَعِيدٍ. So who would be more astray than the one who is far off in enmity? Now you are only refusing to accept it due to enmity against me. Otherwise your hearts have testified to it, that I have not composed this kalam, this book. This is divine, this is coming to me through revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for the last time, this ayah is very profound, very important. سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْآفَاقِ وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُ الْحَقِّ. Soon we shall show to them our signs in the universe as well as within themselves, until it becomes absolutely clear to them that this Quran is the truth. What does it mean? This Quran was revealed 1400 years ago. 14 long centuries have passed. And during the past 2 and 3 centuries, there has been explosion of knowledge. The physical sciences, the knowledge has greatly expanded. But every advancement in scientific knowledge has confirmed Quran. That's what Quran said 1400 years ago was correct. So as this human knowledge is progressing, is advancing, the truthfulness of Quran is being established more and more every day. Just recall the book written by Maurice Boucaille, surgeon, doctor by profession, surgeon, French. King Faisal Shahid actually once went to consult him for some ailment and presented to him a copy of Quran and said to him, he said, how can I understand? He said, okay, you learn some Arabic. Learn. It's not a dead language, it's a living language. Learn Arabic and read it. He did it. And then he wrote the book. He said, there's nothing in Quran which might have been proved wrong by all these inventions and all the discoveries of science. There are so many things in Bible which have been proved false, wrong. The Quran, the Bible and science. Yeah, the Bible, the Quran and science, this is the title of his book. And then he embraced Islam also. And I told you, Dr. Kenneth Moore, he is the biggest embryologist at Toronto University. And he says it's amazing how 1400 years ago, when there was no dissection of bodies, no microscopes, nothing of the sort, these stages of the development of the embryo in the womb of the mothers, how it could be explained. Amazing. So with the passage of time, whatever new knowledge comes to man, it is confirming that Quran is true. سَنُرِيهِمْ, we shall show to them very soon آیاتنا اور سائنس فی الآفاق ان دی ہول آف دی یونیورس وفی انفسہم اینڈ آلسو ود ان دیم امبریولوجی از ود ان دیم حتی یتبین لہم انہ الحق till that they come to believe firmly that this Quran is the truth. اَوَلَمْ يَكْفِ بِرَبِّكَ أَنَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. Is it not sufficient for your Lord that He is witness over everything? أَلَىٰ إِنَّهُمْ فِي مِرْيَةٍ مِّن لِقَائِهِ. Behold, they are in doubt about meeting their Lord. أَلَىٰ إِنَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُحِيطٍ. Behold, He has already encompassed everything. Nobody can run away from Him. Now we come to Surah Shura. This is the climax of these four surahs. And here the subject of practical Tawheed comes reaches its zenith. What is the zenith of Tawheed? The collective system of human life should come under the obedience of Allah, without any exception. Just as a person, as an individual, فَعْبُدِ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ الدِّينَ. Worship Allah, keeping your obedience, absolute obedience, exclusively reserved for Allah. In the same way, this political, socio-economic system of yours, all aspects of this life must be under the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this we call إِقَامَةُ الدِّينَ, establish the deen of Allah. And this surah is the surah of إِقَامَةُ الدِّينَ. And please note, it's my feeling, maybe you also share with me, if not now, sometime in future. For the Muslim Ummah today, our requirements regarding Quran are somewhat different from the requirements of the Sahaba. The Sahaba previously were mushrikeen, non-believers. We are born believers. Different case. We belong to Muslim Ummah. Although our believing is only verbal, but we are believers. We don't challenge. So for the Ummah of today, the most important and most relevant surah in the Makki Quran is Surah Ash-Shura. And most relevant and most important surah of the Madani Quran is Surah Al-Hadid, the last surah of the 27th part. This is my feeling. And as you know, Makki Quran is twice the size of Madani Quran. Madani is one-third. Two-third is Makki. The same ratio proportion is there between the size of Surah Al-Hadid and the size of Surah Ash-Shura. It has 52 ayat, perhaps. Hmm? 53, and that has 29, Surah Al-Hadid. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ha, Mim, Ain, Sin, Qaf. Now this is the second surah which is starting with five alphabets. Three in Quran with one, Surah Qaf, Surah Noon, Surah Sad. We have read only Surah Sad up till now. Then there are so many starting with two. Hamim, Hamim, Taseen, Yaseen, Taha, two. Then three. Alif Lam Mim, Alif Lam Ra. Then four. Alif Lam Mim Saad, Alif Lam Mim Ra. Then five. Two are five. One was Surah Maryam, Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ain, Saad. And second is this. Ha, Mim, Ain, Seen, Kaf. And now this is unique in this respect. The two ayat of this surah are comprising of huruf-e-muqatta'at. Otherwise, either the huruf-e-muqatta'at are not counted as a ayah, or if they are counted, that is one ayah, not two. Here it is two. Hamim, Ain, Sin, Qaf, kazalika yuhi ilayka wa ilal lazina min qablika Allahul Azizul Hakim. In this way, Allah, who is Almighty, the Wise, sends revelation to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to those who were before you. Now, kazalika, what does it mean? That will come in the last of this surah. Kazalika will be explained in the end of this surah. What is the methodology of revelation? But here, you just wait. But Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had the experience. It was coming to him. So Allah is saying, O Muhammad, just as we are revealing this Quran to you, in the same way we have been revealing our books to the former messengers of Allah. لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. To him belongs everything that is in the heavens and everything that is in the earth. وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. And he is the high, the mighty. تَقَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْ فَوْقِهِنَّ. The heavens may are near to be rent asunder from above. وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ. And the angels keep on glorifying Allah with his praise. وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And they keep on asking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the people who dwell in this earth. And we have read that in detail in Surah Al-Ghafir or Surah Al-Mumin. أَلَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Behold, Allah is verily the forgiving, the merciful. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ. As for those who have taken for themselves besides Allah, protectors, Allahu Hafizun Alayhim. There's no protector. Allah is the protector and watcher over them. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِوَكِيلٍ. And O you Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are not a guardian over them. وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ قُرْآنًا. Again, كَذَلِكَ. In this way we have sent or revealed to you this Quran which is Arabic. Quran and Arabian. لِتُنْزِرَ أُمَّ الْقُرَىٰ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا. So that you warn the mother city, mother town. أُمَّ الْقُرَىٰ, Makkah, was the central city of Arabia, Arabian Peninsula. And we have read it before also. حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ فِي أُمِّهَا رَسُولًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has never been destroying any land unless he sent first a messenger to the central town of that area, that locality. So, O Muhammad, you have to warn these people who are living in Makkah, first of all. لِتُنْزِرَ أُمَّ الْقُرَىٰ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا. And those who are around it. وَتُنْزِرَ يَوْمَ الْجَمْعِ. And so that you warn them of the day of gathering, when whole humanity will gather before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا رَيْبَ فِي. In which there is no doubt. فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. One party, one group will be in the garden. وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. The other party or group will be in the blazing fire. وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَجَعَلَهُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. And had Allah wished, He could make you or them all one ummah. وَلَكِنْ يُدْخِلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ فِي رَحْمَتِهِ. But the wisdom of His creation is that He has given man the option. You can go this way or that way. Imma shakiram wa imma kafura. So that now he will admit into his mercy only those whom he wishes. But zalimun, and as for those who are the evil doers, ma lahum min waliyyin wala nasir. For them there will be no protector and no helper. Ami takhadhu min dunihi awliya. Have they taken for themselves besides Allah protectors? Fallahu huwal wali. Allah is the only protector. These are your false thoughts. Allah is the only protector. فَهُوَ الْوَلِيِّ. فَاللَّهُ هُوَ الْوَلِيِّ. وَهُوَ يُحْيِي الْمَوْتَىٰ. And He gives life to the dead. وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. And He is powerful over everything. Now, this subject of system. Human life. The collective aspect of human life. One is the personal life. But you know, much more important today is the collective aspect. If there is something wrong in the collective system, its evil spreads throughout the society. So it has to be a just social order, based on justice, fair play. So, and the first point regarding this is that sovereignty belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this ayah now, in this first ayah of the second section, first of all what is established is that the authority to decide matters is with Allah and Allah alone. وَمَا اخْتَلَفْتُمْ فِيهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. And in whichsoever thing you differ, فَحُكْمَهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. So authority to decide it is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What should be the rights of the husband? What should be the rights of the wife? There can be different views. What are the duties, responsibilities of a husband? What are the duties and responsibilities of a wife? You may differ, but the decision will be given by Allah. What are the rights of the rulers? And what are the rights of the ruled? Who will decide? If you ask the rulers, they will say, we should have the maximum rights. We have to keep the law and order and this and that, so there should be maximum authority in our hands. As far as the ruled people come up to this, we should have the freedom. We don't want a totalitarian state. We don't want a dictatorship. We want to have something in our hands. Who will decide? What's the point of justice? What's the point of balance? Allah will decide. So these are, it's in the same way. Here is the capital, here is the labor. Capital, it wants its share. It wants to dominate. It demands the lion's share. Labor says, no. Capital itself is nothing. It's our labor that has gained everything. We deserve more. But who will decide? The capitalist would say, will present his case, and the labor would present their case. Who will decide? Allah. وَمَا اخْتَلَفْتُمْ فِيهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَحُكْمُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبِّي. He is Allah, my Lord. عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ. I have put all of my trust in Him. وَإِلَيْهِ أُنِيب. And to Him I turn my face. فَاطِرِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. He is the originator of the heavens and the earth. جَعَلَ لَكُم مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. He has made from your own selves, your species, spouses for you. وَمِنَ الْأَنْعَامِ أَزْوَاجًا. And in the same way for the cattle, there are spouses. Species, sexes. Species is the same, but sex is different. يَزْرَعُكُمْ فِيهِ. Due to this difference of sexes, He multiplies you. Procreation. Procreation is through this difference of sex. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ. There is nothing, 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 none like Him. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. And He is all seeing, all listening. لَهُ مَقَالِيدُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. To He belong all the keys of the heavens and the earth. يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. For whomsoever He likes, He outspreads the sustenance. And for whomsoever He likes, He straightens it or restricts it. إِنَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٌ. He knows everything. If He is outspreading, it is also based on His knowledge. If He is restricting, this is also based on His knowledge. There is nothing haphazard. شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ. Now comes the key ayah of this surah. And in this respect I may say, the key ayah of the Qur'an. On the subject of اِقَامَةُ الدِّينِ, this is the key ayah of the whole Qur'an. شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ. For you, O Muslims, O followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have ordained as deen the same thing, مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا, which we had ordained to Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ. And that which we have revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى. And what we had enjoined on Ibrahim and Musa and Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. What does it mean? The deen has been the same throughout. From day one, till the last day, deen is the same. What is the deen? Deen comprises of two things. Allah is your Lord and ruler. You have to worship Him and obey Him. And His messenger is His representative. So, the obedience to Allah will be through the obedience to His messenger. Now, when the messenger was Moses, whatever commandments came through him, you had to follow. When the messenger was Jesus, whatever commandments came to you through him, you had to follow. And now finally, our messenger is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What we have sent to him, you have to obey. This is the... In principle, there has been no difference whatsoever in deen. There has been difference in sharia's. We had the ayah in Surah Al-Ma'idah. لِكُلِّنْ جَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ شِرْعَةً وَمِنْ هَاجَا. For each ummah from amongst you, we fixed a sharia and a minhaj. Sharia, the law. The law of Moses was somewhat different from the law of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Shariat-e-Musvi, Shariat-e-Muhammadi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The rules regarding the psalm, fasting, in the former sharia were different. In our sharia, different. The form of salah in the former sharia was different. In our sharia, it is different. Methodology was also different. In the methodology of Musa, the priority was to get a nation which was oppressed badly, to get freedom for it. That was priority number one. On the first meeting with Fir'aun, the demand was placed, "An arsil ma'ana bani Israel." Now let the children of Israel go with us. The methodology of Jesus was different. Methodology of Ibrahim was different. I spoke at this subject at length 2 years before at our annual Central of Tanzeem-e-Islami in Karachi. These are the methodologies, minhaj. But minhaj-e-Muhammadi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's a revolutionary minhaj, a revolutionary methodology. Why? The why answer to it, why is coming now? We have understood from this first part of this ayah. شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليك وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى. We have ordained you to, for you as a deen the same as we ordained to Nuh, to Ibrahim, to Musa and Isa. And which we now have revealed to you, O Muhammad. And what is your duty now? أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه. We have perfected our deen on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum, wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati, wa raditu lakum al-islam ad-deena. Now it's the duty of the ummah to establish this deen. An aqimu ad-deen wa la tatafarraqu fi. So that you establish this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth, actually, practically. And don't differ regarding this deen and iqamatu ad-deen. You can have differences in Sharia. For example, whether when you are praying, should you keep your hands here or here or let them loose? You can differ. But in Iqamatuddin and Deen, the two principles of Deen, sovereignty to Him, final authority to Him, and His obedience through the obedience of the Messenger of Allah. This should remain firm. And to establish this system should be your foremost priority. The first duty of a truly believing mu'min is to strive to establish the deen of Allah. If he is not doing it, he has so somehow accepted the deen of batil, taghut. He has reconciled with it. He is at peace with it. He is serving it. He is trying to prosper under it. Then he has no relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِالْتَاغُوتِ وَيُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ. You have to do kufr with taghut first and then believe in Allah. Unless you do kufr with taghut. to detach yourself from Tagut. You might have to live there, but you have to live, which you say, in protest. Living in protest. And taking from that system only the minimum thing which is required for your subsistence. And rest of your time, your money, your resources, your intelligence, your understanding, whatever Allah has bestowed you upon you, should be reserved for the struggle to change this system. Topple over this Taghut and this Nizam-e-Batil and establish the deen of Allah over this earth. An aqimu ad-deen wa la tatafarraqu fih. Now let us complete this ayah. Now before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were two groups. One were the ummiyin, who didn't know what is book and what is prophethood and what is messengerhood and what is sharia. They never knew it. And the other were the people of the book. Regarding the first, Allah says, kabur alal mushrikeena ma tad'uhum ilayh. O Muhammad, it's very hard on these mushrikeen associated with Allah, what you are calling them towards. To give up their false gods, the gods of their fathers, forefathers, their national traditions. How can they do it? So don't think that people will rally around you very easily. You will call and they will come. Oh, no, no. Very hard times are ahead. You will have to work very hard, very hard, very hard. Don't have false hopes that very soon people will accept it. No. Kabura ala al-mushrikeena ma tad'uhum ilayh. It's very hard for these mushrikeen. But you are calling them. Not easy for them to accept. Allahu yajtabi ilayhi man yasha. But there's a ray of hope. Allah chooses for himself whosoever he wishes. Sometimes he chooses himself. Okay, come on. Just as Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He came out of his house with the view to kill Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Drawn out sword in his hand. But then, in the very route, he was told, your sister and brother-in-law, they have converted to Islam. You know this incident, this historical fact. So this is whom Allah is Taba. He was going somewhere else, Allah called him, no, come here, Umar, don't go that way. And then number two is, وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُنِيب. Whosoever turns towards him and wishes to be guided to him, Allah surely will guide him also. So there are two types of persons. One are the persons who themselves seek guidance. For them, the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that he will definitely give them guidance. But there are others also, he might not be seeking, but maybe that Allah pulls them himself using his prerogative, his authority. As for the people of the book, the next ayah is discussing is, I think the time is over. And these guys seeing to me again and again. So I finish here. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'ni wa iyaakum bil ayati wa zikri al-hakim.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about Iona, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.